Ashton Kutcher, model, actor, producer, philanthropist, and tech-savvy investor. How exactly did he multiply his wealth 8 times over? We'll answer that in today's episode.
My name is Dan Henry, and when I was 16 years old, I decided that I wanted to be rich. So I studied as many wealthy entrepreneurs as I could and used what I learned to create my own successful business. The purpose of this channel is to share my research with the world and show you how they got rich.
While most of the world may think of him as the airhead Kelso from That 70s Show, that is a far cry from the truth about Ashton Kutcher. Acting has been a springboard for Kutcher to put his investment skills to use, creating a net worth of $200 million, making him one of the world's wealthiest actors. The world doesn't know Ashton. Christopher Ashton Kutcher was one of two Kutcher boys born on February 7, 1978. His twin brother Michael was born with cerebral palsy and would teach Ashton the true meaning of unconditional love. When the boys were just 13, Michael's heart was failing him, and his only hope was a transplant. Ashton was so concerned for his twin's survival that he was willing to give his own heart so his brother could live. Miracles do happen, and Ashton's brother is proof of that. An organ donation was found, and a transplant saved his life. Ashton did not stop worrying about his brother, though. To avoid being home and bearing the weight of more bad news, he kept himself busy with activities at school, which would serve as the foundation for his acting career. In high school, Chris, as he was known to his classmates, pursued the stage and developed an affinity for it. His first appearances on stage would be in a little Iowa farming town of 500. Not only did Ashton hit the stage for plays, but he was also known for grabbing the mic in musicals. If you want proof, you can find Ashton Kutcher on YouTube singing his heart out with his very own rendition of Billy Dean's If There Hadn't Been You. Kutcher manages to bring both drama and comedy into this flannel-clad, black hat-wearing performance. But what stands out about Ashton's high school career is what he chose at the end. When it came time to decide on college, he wanted a school that would allow him to study biochemical engineering because 18-year-old Kutcher wanted to cure his brother's heart disease. So he enrolled at the University of Iowa in the fall of 1996. After joining a fraternity and experiencing frat life, Ashton hit the books pretty hard. He managed to study and work several odd jobs to pay for his schooling, including grabbing a broom at General Mills and sweeping up cereal dust. In 1997, a stranger named Mary Clark walked up to Ashton and told him he needed to enter the Fresh Faces of Iowa modeling contest. Ever the gamer, he entered. And he won. The keen eye of a stranger would be the catalyst for his modeling career. Soon after winning, Kutcher headed to New York City and signed on with a modeling agency. Calvin Klein and Abercrombie & Fitch picked him up as talent and featured his photos in their ad campaigns. He traveled internationally doing runway shows in both Paris and Milan. With a college career now off the table, Ashton would once again pursue acting. In the spring of 1998, he landed his first big break. He was cast as one of the main characters on That 70s Show. The show would run for 8 seasons, and the beloved role of Kelso would make Ashton Kutcher famous. His first film debut was the lesser-known film Coming Soon, shortly after followed by the comedy hit Dude, Where's My Car? That was just the beginning. Kutcher would go on to appear in 37 television shows and films. He played every role from comedy to his dark psychological thriller role in The Butterfly Effect. Though his portrayal of Kelso firmly established his assumed reputation as a total goofball and prankster, Kutcher would use that to his advantage and co-create the TV show Punked. He would not only successfully serve as the mischievous superstar pranking host, but also as the show's producer for the 10 seasons it ran. From Punked alone, Kutcher made $11 million. For every episode Kelso played, Kutcher would receive $750,000. Those are just two examples of the money flowing in his direction. Christopher Ashton Kutcher had become a well-paid, in-demand celebrity, and the world adored him. Posing on stage with his life-sized surfboard trophy in 2003, Ashton would accept the first of his 3 Teen Choice Awards, Reality Hunk of the Year, Choice Reality / Variety Host, and Choice Actor in a Comedy. In total, 14 Teen Choice Awards would be given to Kutcher over the next few years. In the years that followed, Kutcher stepped into the role of actor, producer, and celebrity, number 3 on the 100 Hottest Hotties, according to VH1 in 2003. He would also marry his first wife, Demi Moore, and amass $25 million career dollars. $25 million is not quite in the ballpark of $200 million. So what did Ashton Kutcher do to create $175 million in additional wealth? Never underestimate a man with great work ethic, unfailing sense of humor, dimples for days, and an IQ of 160. Yes, Ashton Kutcher has an IQ sitting quite close to genius level, a truth that places him in the top 5% of the world's reported intelligence. Further proof that he is not just a pretty face. He may play hard, but he works harder. Kutcher once said, "I don't believe that old cliche that good things come to those who wait. I think good things come to those who want something so bad they can't sit still." From a young age, he knew how to get what he wanted. He practiced patience and diligence. At only 13 years of age, Ashton wanted a snowmobile, so he worked for it. After school and on weekends for 18 long months, he put away every penny. He saved $1,400. That work ethic, combined with his keen mind, allowed him the ability to make several genius decisions. In 2010, he partnered with Guy O'Siri and Ron Burkle to found the venture capital firm A-Grade Investments. Their goal was somewhat philanthropic in nature. They wanted to invest in technology startups that were adding value to people's lives. A-Grade would put money towards companies such as Airbnb, Spotify, SoundCloud, Shazam, and Uber. Kutcher was convinced to invest $1 million in Spotify in 2009. Upon its sale to Microsoft about a year and a half later, his money had quadrupled. He was hooked. In 2011, Kutcher and business partner Guy O'Siri invested $500,000 in Uber. By 2016, their stake was valued at 100 times more than what they initially paid. In April of that same year, Forbes would feature Ashton on their cover page as one of tech's top investors and name him to the 2016 Midas list of the 100 best venture capitalists. Kutcher knows tech startups. He speaks their language fluently, and he is well respected in their circles. But that isn't all he knows. He knows people. He knows philanthropy. He knows compassion. He knows that children are being paid for and traded like cheap cattle. So he did something about it. He and ex-wife Demi Moore founded Thorn. Kutcher took his passion for people and his tech savvy to design a company that builds technology to defend against sexual abuse. They want to end sex trafficking and online sexual exploitation of children. Ashton would even testify to this in front of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee in 2017. So much of what Ashton learned about tenacity and compassion came from his connection to his twin brother Michael. "My brother was born with cerebral palsy, and it taught me that loving people isn't a choice and that people aren't actually all created equal. We're all created incredibly unequal to one another in our capabilities and what we can do and how we think and what we see, but we all have the equal capacity to love one another, and my brother taught me that." The media underestimated Ashton Kutcher. They dubbed him a handsome ditz. They labeled him in haste, in ignorance. They did not know all there is to know about Ashton Kutcher. If you want to know him, you can just text him. That's right, his desire to connect with his fellow man is so great that he publicly gave out his personal number on Twitter. Christopher Ashton Kutcher is a good man. He is brilliant, and he is a genuinely nice guy who just happens to be worth $200 million. You can't keep a good man down.
Hey, Dan Henry here, and I hope you enjoyed this episode of How They Got Rich. I created this channel because these men and women inspired me to quit my job years ago as a pizza boy and pursue entrepreneurship, which eventually led me to become a multi-millionaire. If you'd like to know more about that, you can follow me on my main YouTube channel, youtube.com/Dan Henry. But before you go, I'd like to remind you why the people on this channel are successful, as well as myself. It's because they've mastered three main areas of their life: business, productivity, and mindset. And that's why I've made it my life's work to help others in those three key areas. So here are three ways I can help you right now. If you own a business and you're looking to grow it, you can head over to getclients.com and learn how we built a $20 million business, as well as learn how these strategies can apply to your business. You'll find a collection of free trainings, podcasts, and blog posts on that website to help you grow your business. As well, you can grab a free copy of my book, Digital Millionaire Secrets, which is a Wall Street Journal and USA Today bestseller. You can find that on getclients.com. Number two, you can head over to plantomorrow.com and check out the Plan Tomorrow Daily Planner. This is a planner I personally designed to make myself more productive and get things done. Because the truth is, if you want to do big things, you have to get things done. And I know this planner will help change your life like it's changed mine. For a limited time, it also comes with a free productivity class taught by me. So head over there right now and grab yourself a copy. And finally, number three, if you're struggling with mindset, confidence, motivation, imposter syndrome, or you're just looking to develop a rock solid mindset so you can achieve more in life, then I want you to head over to howtothink.com, where we have daily mindset mentoring on how to achieve anything in life by changing the way you think. So grab a copy of your Plan Tomorrow Daily Planner now. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next episode.